And then the scripture starts with, then one of the 12, called Judas Iscariot, went unto the chief priests and said unto them, what will you give me? And I will deliver him unto you. And they convened with him for 30 pieces of silver. From that time, he saw opportunity to betray him. This title that I will be given for this sermon will be the Academy Awards Masquerade. The Academy Awards are given out to actors and actresses for the best acting in a movie, TV, or play. The actors are masquerading around being someone who they are not. We find in the scripture previous to 14 through 16, if I may, that there is a lot going on up to the scriptures. In the beginning of this chapter, we find Jesus is letting his disciples know that 2 days after the Passover, he will be delivered up to be crucified. As we move along, we find the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes all gathered together, plotting to kill Jesus. Where he is with Mary, and she is pouring some expensive oil on him. Jesus and his disciples think that that is a waste. But Jesus let them know that she has done a good work for him, and after all, she did it because it's for his burial. Now we arrive where Judas makes his deal. And if I may ask this question, why would Judas betray Jesus? Why? I want you to run this through your mind. Ask yourself that question. Why would Judas betray Jesus? You got to come to realize that Judas was one of the 12 disciples. Why would he want to betray Jesus? Judas, we must realize that he walked with Jesus on a daily basis. Why would Judas want to betray Jesus? Judas was taught many things by Jesus. He was a treasurer, and he saw Jesus' miracles. So why would he want to betray Jesus? I'm here to tell you why. What could have been on Judas' mind? Do you think that it was for the love of money? And after all, he did dip into the money box. Or maybe he thought he might get in good with the chief priests and the scribes. In reading your scriptures, you'll find that Judas never called him Lord like the other disciples, but call him Rabbi, which acknowledged Jesus as nothing but a teacher in Sunday school. And that just happened this morning. The pastor was teaching, and he asked a question. And it was, if you had a chance to be someone else, who would you want to be? Which brings us up to the Academy Awards. Some of us, like Judas, are trusted in the church, but yet we wear a masquerade. We pretend to be close to Jesus, but we're not. I'm guessing that some are saying in their mind that I do love the Lord. I'm not the one to say you do or you don't. But I do know that our actions on Sunday morning service is different once we leave the church. We must trust in the Lord with all our heart and lean not to our understanding. We must take off our masquerade and be what the Lord wants us to be. We talk about when we give testimony that God is the head of our life, but we do everything contrary to His word. If I keep it 100, as you all say, I try to preach. Yes, I did, like other ministers and other pastors. Yes, I try to preach it like you, Pastor. I try to tell stories like the pastor did. But God said, be what I want you to be and preach my word. I want y'all to know that I wore a mask because I was trying to be the preacher like the one that I have seen. But God said, be who you are. I started like Jonas running away. When He sent me one place, I went another place. And I tried to act like you, Pastor. But I couldn't tell the stories the way you said it. I want you to know that Reverend Benel, I also try to be like you. I have many mentors up here that I try to be like, but God told me, be who you are. Amen. Oh, I try to be like you, Reverend Benel, but I couldn't jump up and down. That ain't me, but God kept telling me, be who you are. God has given each and every one of us a place, and He told us what we need to do. But we yet wear a masquerade on Sunday and not do the will of God. I want you to know right now, I didn't leave you out either, Reverend Gad, because I tried to sing and scream like you, Reverend Gad, but God said I didn't give you the voice to sing. I want you to know right now that we gotta stop wearing a mask and being who God wants us to be, because only God can make us who we are supposed to be. I'm here to tell somebody right now, in the name of Jesus, quit wearing that mask and be who you are. Don't be the same way you are on the outside. Be who you are on the inside, because God wants you to be a great, strong witness for Him. Isaac said, seek the Lord while He may be found, and call upon Him while He is near. We need to stop looking for the things of the world and call upon the name of Jesus. I'm here to tell you what I'm at work. Sometimes I want to just tell these people who they really are. But because of my position, I got to keep a smile on my face. You don't know what you got to go through, but I'm here to tell you that when you wear the face of God, there's unconditional love in your heart. When you wear the face of God, your walk begins to match up with your talk. I'm here to tell you right now, don't be that backstabber trying to take somebody's place and then come in church with a smiling face. I'm here to tell you, don't say that you love me when you hate me. Don't say that you will when you won't. I'm here to tell you that we've got to be the children of God today, because there's somebody on the outside of this church looking at you and saying, I thought they was a Christian. I thought they was a child of God. Look at the way they act. And then you want to come into the church and say, children of God. David said that the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want, because he knew that God is a provider. God will provide you whatever you need when you need it. We got to learn that once we get in the body of Christ, we don't need to go to someone else, when God should be the first one that we go to. We got to quit masquerading around and be Christ-like, giving unconditional love, praying for one another, exalting one another. Far too many of us come into the church on Sunday morning, lifting each other up and walking out of the door saying, I cannot stand him. They got on my last nerve. That ain't Christ-like. Take off that mask and be who you are for God to change you. After all, you need to confess with your mouth and say the Lord Jesus, and he was raised from the dead. I'm here to tell you that if you call on the name of Jesus, he'll take that addiction mind away from you. If you call on the name of Jesus, he will take away that abusive person in your life. Someone ought to shout hallelujah, because the mask has came down and God knows who you are. You can hide it from me, but you cannot hide it from God. I'm here to tell somebody right now, I don't care who you are, how great or education you got, your status in life, God knows who you really are. You're not as nice as you think you are. You've been sitting in the church for years and years, but yet your attitude has not changed. You ought to think about who you are in the body of Christ. You've been sitting in the church all this time, thinking that you're the best singer, but God got someone else that can sing better than you. You got to be who you are. I'm here to tell somebody right now that you know that church starts at 11 and you show up at 12. God knows who you are. You think that God don't know you? God knows every hair on your head. I'm here to tell you, he knows you're rising up and you're coming down. Take off the mask and quit pretending to be a Christian. If you want to be one, then you need to act like one. We need to all come up to the pulpit on every Sunday and ask God for forgiveness, because once you begin to ask for forgiveness and he begins to change who you are, then you'll be able to become that great church member. And when you become a great church member, you begin to know how to treat each other right. You begin to understand the sermon and messages that are given. You begin to want to do what you need to do in the church. I'm here to tell somebody, we got to take off the mask.
Yes, yes.
Some of us are getting an award for being the best actor and actresses.
Come on, Reverend.
Some of us, we may not get the award for the best actor, but we was nominated for it. I'm here to tell somebody right now, we got to quit playing the role of a Christian that we're not. We need to give life to Christ. Because the Bible did say that all of us, every last one of us, have sinned and came short of the glory. I'm here to tell you, I'm not saying that I'm all that, because I know that I've been acting like I'm somebody that I ain't. But I'm here to tell you right now that I got to be who I am so God can use me the way he wants to use me. I cannot go on to go around preaching like somebody else. I got to preach the way God told me to preach. And if I can't preach the way he wants me to preach it, then I need to sit on down, because it ain't me. God is a good God. God is the one that gave me life. God is the one that keeps me straight. I'm here to may not have, so that you may have more life and have it abundantly. God is a good God.
Yes.
And when he rose, he took the sting out of the death. There's no more pain now. But what we got to do is be who we were supposed to be. We're supposed to be out there witnessing for Christ. We're supposed to be bringing in the sheep instead of pushing the sheep on out. I'm here to tell you, once you get Christ into your life, your walk is going to change. Your talk is going to change. You're going to begin to love those that you did not like. You're going to begin to correct those that push you away. God will give you a whole new life.
Yes, he will.
All right now.
Yeah.
There's another great book you all read. It's How to Be a Great Church Member. Because some of us don't know how to be a great church member. Because we're so busy trying to get back at somebody that we don't like. But in order to be a great church member, you got to give your life to Christ. And come out to these studies. Come out to the Sunday schools.
Right.
We got to learn who Christ is and what he can do for us. We just can't hear about it. We got to know about it. The Bible tells us to study, to show ourselves approved workmen. Be not be ashamed, but being able to rightfully divide the word of truth. Oh, you can listen to me all day long. I might not be telling you what's right, but if you know what God But I'm here to tell somebody right now, we got to quit trying to win that award for the Academy Awards. Because all man has nothing to offer you. I'm here to tell somebody right now that today is your day. Don't worry about what anybody else say. If you call on the name of Jesus, he will be there. We got to understand that God is an awful God. He is the Almighty, Lord of Lords and King of Kings. He is the one that gave his life for you and I.